Time now for Ask Kelly and the topic everyone has been asking about, spotted lanternflies. Jackie Dapper Friday says they are crawling all over the outside of our house and on the windows. We've not been able to sit on our back deck the whole month of August. Michelle Kotzman says that they are so gross, they fly in your face. She's not wrong. Susan Watson says we need help and hope. These creepy bugs are everywhere. And guys, if you're like me and you grew up here, you know we never had these things before. So why are they so bad lately? And will it be this way forever? I got you some answers, and stick with me because there is reason to have hope.
I was scared. They're everywhere and they keep landing on me.
Get rid of them.
Yes, they're flying everywhere. I was a little overwhelmed.
We were hoping 2024 would be the year that they'd disappear as fast as they came to Western Pennsylvania. We were overly optimistic.
But hopefully our newly elected president will have a great idea on what we should do about the lanternflies.
Spotted lanternflies have been in the U.S. since 2014, but it was really just in the past year or two that these plant hoppers exploded in our area. Remember this? Our own Bob Mayo filed this report last August from Penn Center in Wilkins Township.
That's right. These are an invasive species. They've been invading our personal space as we've been covering the story today.
We decided to come back out this year to see if things have gotten any better, and not really.
I believe the spotted lanternfly came from parts of Asia. I think the native range is China, maybe Vietnam.
Brandon McCracken with the Pittsburgh Parks Conservancy takes us to Frick Park and explains their origins.
I believe the suspect was a shipping of decorative stone to eastern Pennsylvania. Might have had some lanternfly eggs attached to it.
Because they're not native, they're considered invasive. And the reason their population has exploded the way it has is because they have no real predators yet.
And I'm brushing them off.
Well, except for us. But it is a losing battle to kill the ones you see because there always seems to be more. But as Pittsburgh's own Jeff Goldblum put it best,
life finds a way.
Nature is going to help us out. This is not necessarily our new normal, right?
Yeah, definitely not. You know, from what I've heard, from what researchers have kind of observed in other cities, they found that maybe after 2, 3, 4 years, that's kind of around the peak year.
After the peak comes the drop off. That's because different animals, insects, even bacteria and fungi will realize they can use the lanternflies, thus curbing their population back to something more reasonable. Think the stink bug invasion of the early 2010s.
I don't think we need to sort of fear this level of lanternflies forever.
We're right at about year 4 of our new neighbors in Western Pennsylvania, meaning this could be the peak. But keep in mind, that could differ location to location. If you're not seeing a ton in your area right now, you could still be facing the peak in the years to come. But this is good news for Penn Center and other areas that look like this. Speaking of, why are these things attracted to office buildings? There are a ton downtown too, which is strange considering they feed on plants.
They kind of rely on climbing tall structures, you know, usually trees, but in this case maybe buildings, and kind of getting a boost for themselves to glide or flutter to new locations.
Brandon also says they may be attracted to the heat of the buildings. Now, the one spot you are guaranteed to see them is on the Tree of Heaven, also an invasive species, and where we shot this interview.
If someone were to say, simply cut down the tree, you know, fell it with a chainsaw like any other species of tree, a lot of times what you see is that root system that does still have life in it. Its response to the tree being cut down is to send up hundreds, maybe thousands of young, brand new trees in the next year or two.
Some of the tree's features include bark that looks like cantaloupe skin and leaves made up of a couple dozen leaflets. And there will likely be boatloads of spotted lanternflies hanging out on the trunk. In fact, stand close enough to one of these trees and you'll see what looks like rain. Word to the wise, that is actually honeydew or lanternfly excrement. Your best bet to remove a Tree of Heaven from your property is to call a professional. For everyone else, Penn State Extension offers a lanternfly guide on its website with instructions on how to make traps. And hang in there. We're going to get some hope from New Jersey here. They were closer to the original invasion and had their peak a few years ago. We found this group visiting from Jersey who told us their town used to look like Pittsburgh, and now it is much better.
Still see one or two, but not to like that extent.
I was used to it about three or four years ago. They were really, really bad where we were, and you couldn't go outside without being covered in them. And I had gotten so used to them not being around anymore.
I haven't even really thought about them until we got here.
Wouldn't that be a nice place to be to not think about them? Well, in the short term, we are almost to the end of lanternfly season. They're going to lay their eggs this fall. Then a few good freezes will kill off this current generation. And again, if things go according to plan, the place is getting overrun, should start to see fewer next year and then in the subsequent years. And more good news, researchers do say they're not damaging forests and native plants as originally feared. Their biggest risk, though, is to grapevines. Vineyard owners across the country are now having to find ways to protect their crops.